This time we'll take it slow. This ain't a movie, no. No fairy tale conclusion, y'all. That's tough. That's hard work, that. It's very, very hard work. For example, it's 6 o'clock this evening. We might have detected that there's going to be a threat 30 kilometers to our east. Then we'll move teams in there, and we have permanent little stations for them where they will operate from, move out, dig a hole, lie in a sleeping bag under a tree, and wait. So if the poachers do breach our borders, they know they're going to go and target that group of rhinos over there. Those guys will intercept those poachers. Then the next morning they get up and they walk back to their little picket, their little tent under a tree with a thorny corral around it, and then we'll go and drop off 25 liters of water that must last them for 3 days. And that their rations are dry rations. They don't carry heavy tins or anything that needs water to cook it. I mean, sometimes you can't even cook that stuff. So there's a lot of dry rations, we call it. But like the ration packs that we used to have in the army. Okay, and they just get on with it. And once they've done, once the threat is over, then we'll bring them back to a safe house, we call it, where they can watch TV and sleep and have a nice hot shower and so on and so on. And then they get deployed back out there again. We were caught with our pants down with the rhino threat. We never had that element on our reserves. We suddenly had to get that element. We never had an opportunity to budget for it over time, you know, and to increase that resource. So we got them in. They are earning, in my opinion, a fraction of what they're worth. And if you want to correlate it with the value of the resource that they are protecting, you know, are you going to pay somebody 200 euros to protect the crown jewels? He's going to look at those crown jewels and say, my goodness, they're worth millions.
If us, we don't do this job, who will do it? If there is no someone who will say, okay, I volunteer to do the job to save the elephants, to save the rhinos, who is going to do it? Nobody will do it. So at some point, we have to take a stand like, okay, we are women, we are black members, we are going to stand for this. And we are tired of seeing each and every day on the TV, like, there are some rhinos that are killed. And horrible. Not like they just cut it nice and then they leave it to live. They just kill it so horrible. So we just want to stop this thing. And those people are our brothers, our fathers, but yet we have to stop them.
If one of my rangers, and it happens, okay, shoots a poacher, whether the poacher dies or not, is either attempted murder, or unlawful use of firearm, or whatever it is. There's a whole lot of different charges that they get. Negligent use of firearm, there's 101 things. Then you must prove that it was necessary to defend your life or the life of your other rangers, and that's why you shot that guy. Going to be, and it's very tough. It's the last court case where one of our guys shot a poacher here cost almost 100,000 rand in lawyer's fees. The influence of that is not the financial influence, okay, the impact of that. The impact is on the rest of our field rangers now. They would rather hide and wait for the poachers to walk past and then whisper on the radio that they can see some poachers and they will shoot them. And the guy thinks, you've got to be crazy. I'm not going to jail for this job for 3,500 rand a month. You know, where's the incentive here? So, I mean, we've got lawyers and what have you on retainer that will fly out and assist. The legal system is a little bit sympathetic to the cause, but the communities will get worked up and whipped up, and then the magistrate's decision is difficult, you know. It becomes a little less impartial. You know, when you've got a community ranting and raving in the background, they want justice, and they want justice because every time their uncle walks through the reserve, he gets shot at.